Welcome to TNPSC 360 degree. Today we are going to see the Hindu analysis for the 21st November 2018. So come, let us read the newspaper together. So if you have not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe now and press the bell icon to get the regular notifications. So the first article, front page article, not much of importance, but still, a blast at the ammunition depot in the Wardha leaves 6 dead. So ammunition depot is in Wardha, Maharashtra. Okay, so it is a place where the ammunitions will be stored of the defense department. Okay, so ordnance factory, there are 39 ordnance factories in India. It comes under ordnance factories board under the defense ministry. Okay, so this is the factories where the defense equipments are manufactured. So this incident occurred when there was a disposal of the unserviceable ordinances. So it has, the six people have been killed. Okay, this is the symbol of Indian ordnance factories. So next important article is the Supreme Court Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi has criticized the criticized the action of the case, the people who are involved in the Alok Verma case. So the constant leaking of the critical report, critical evidences, or the critical discussions about the Alok Verma case to the media has irritated the Supreme Court. So the Chief Justice of India has said, so the highest degree of confidentiality is to be maintained, but we see litigant has gone ahead and given everything to everybody. So the lack of the maintenance of confidentiality, because CBI is a premier investigation on office of India, and this has to be maintained with utmost confidentiality. But everything sensitive charges is being shared with the media. So this has led to the irritation of the Chief Justice. So he has postponed the hearing to November 29th. So there is a controversy between Special Director Rakesh Astana and Director Alok Verma of CBI. So both of them were sent on leave by the Union Government, and the interim director of CBI was appointed. Nageshwar Rao was appointed as the interim director. So there is accusation of the bribing, okay, in the meat merchant, okay, case of Hyderabad. Okay, so this has led to bribe accusation over each other by Rakesh Astana and Alok Verma. So this has led to all the controversy. So 34 years after the anti-Sikh riots, man has been sentenced to death. So in 1984, there was anti-Sikh riots. So why it was created? So why it happened? Because former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi was killed by her Sikh bodyguards as a revenge for her Operation Blue Star. So Operation Blue Star was the operation by the Indian Army against the Khalistan separatist activist who were hiding in the Sikh sacred temple in Amritsar. Okay, Golden Temple. So this, they were flushed out by Operation Blue Star. So it was Indira Gandhi who ordered Operation Blue Star. So in order to revenge it, her Sikh bodyguards killed her, okay, on October 24th. So in the aftermath of October 24th, there was large-scale anti-Sikh riots in Delhi and other states. So this, there was a lot of death and carnage. So 34 years after the anti-Sikh riots, a man has been sentenced to death. So this is the case. So when Jain clash, so who are the Jains? It is USA and China trade war. So this article talks about the USA-China trade war. So the protectionist policy of America, that is the America first policy and unfair trade practices, okay, which it is taking place like the H-1B visa or the America first policy. So it is becoming more protectionist. So, and the tariff war which is going on between China and USA. So they are imposing tariffs on the imports from other countries, in the respective countries. That is, USA is imposing the tariffs, high tariffs up to 50%, from 10% it has increased to 25%. So China has also imposed up to $60 billion of the tariffs on USA. So this has led to war between the both countries, trade war. Okay, so what is the controversy? So the main issue is, the they want the their own safeguard. Okay, they want the own protectionism. So there is a trade gap between both the countries. So the Beijing's Belt Road Initiative has worried the small nations, Asian countries, and because the Asia's the China's expansionist policy is affecting all the Asian countries. The Belt Road Initiative and the China Beijing's policies. Okay, this has led to Maritime Silk Road Initiative, also the String of Pearls String of Pearls theory. You should remember String of Pearls theory, Belt Road Initiative, China Pakistan Economic Corridor. So why China Pakistan Economic Corridor is being opposed by India? It is passing through Pak occupied Kashmir, so it has been opposed by India. So it is against the sovereignty of India. So all these points you should remember. So this clash between the giants, that is USA and China, can lead to reduction in the global economic output, and it can choke the maritime pathways because of the protectionist policy. So what all it can lead to? It has led to the reduction in the global economic output outlook. So the IMF has reduced the global economic output by 3.2%. So, and there may be choking of the international maritime routes, okay, by the protectionist policy. So this has led to the sluggish international economy. So next article, give and take. So on November 19, there was a RBI board meeting between government and the RBI board. So there was a discussion of the many issues, like the MSME sector relaxation or the capitalization, and the liquidity for the non-banking financial companies, and governance issues of the RBI, and the stressed relief for the MSME, and the capital adequacy ratio for the Basel norms. So these were the some of the issues that were discussed. So the Section 7 of RBI Act, which was not used in the history of 83 years of the history of RBI, is not being imposed on RBI. So RBI meeting was held for 9 hours. The deliberations was held for 9 hours. So some of the issues were addressed and some of the issues have been postponed for the next meeting on December 14. So liquidity for non-banking finance corporation, which saw a crunch after the IL and FS crisis. So this is a main issue, and the governance issues of the RBI. So what is government accusing RBI of? The RBI couldn't control the controversies or the incidents like Punjab National Bank fraud, that is the Nirav Modi and the Mehul Chosky case, and also the IL and FS crisis. So the government is accusing the RBI, and the talking of the issues in public by the deputy governor Viral Acharya, one of the deputy governors, talked about the differences between the government and RBI in public. So this should not happen in future. So all these things you have to keep in mind. So one more important article about the demonetization. On November 8, 2016, the high valued currencies of rupees 500 and 1000 were demonetized by the government of India. So this was demonetized for mainly three factors. That is for the fake currencies, to root out the fake currencies and to root out the black money or parallel economy and to reduce the corruption. Okay, so these three were the main reasons given by the government. But how was the impact on the rural areas? So this report has been given by the Agricultural Ministry, Union Agricultural Ministry. So there was a severe crunch for the money to buy seeds and fertilizers for the rabi crops. So rabi is the winter crop and kharif is the summer crop. So the rabi, which was to be sowed in the November December months, there was a severely hit, and there was a reduced sowing area. Net sowing area was reduced because there is more ATMs and the more availability of the alternative cash withdrawal mechanism in the cities compared to rural areas. The urban areas were very much balanced, but in rural areas there is day-to-day transaction happens with the cash, so there is less use of non-cash mechanisms. So this severely hit the agriculture practices during that period. So this report talks about that. So Odisha House passes the 33% reservation for women. So Odisha government, Navin Patnaik government, has passed the 33% reservation in the legislative assemblies and parliament for the women. So this is the historic move by the Odisha government. So in 1992 itself, Biju Patnaik, father of Navin Patnaik, had passed the 33% reservation for women in the local bodies. So now it has increased to 50%. Okay, so Odisha has always been the forefront in the local women empowerment. So the 108 constitutional amendment bill, 108 constitutional amendment bill, which provides reservation for the women in the parliament, is still pending. It has not been passed by the parliament. Okay, 108th constitutional amendment is still pending in the parliament. So social media controversy has erupted over the Jack Dorsey. Okay, he had visited recently India to give a speech in IIT Delhi. So he had released an app, okay, power of 18, to encourage the youth of India to vote in the next general elections. So he is the CEO of Twitter. Okay, so what is the controversy now? He has been holding a placard or the board which says stop Brahmanical patriarchy. So this has led to the controversy in India. So this has become a troll, okay, in Twitter. So social media itself has been entwined in the controversy. So you have to remember Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey and what is the controversy. So this has led to severe backlashing in the social media. So next is the about a Google app called Neighbourly. So in our some days back we had talked about the Google Neighbourly app, which helps in the finding out the easy way of locating the neighborly features, that is which is the least where is the least traffic available, who is the most cheaper tutor for your kids, and which where is the park for the kids, and where is the food available in that time, and where is the hospital open at that time. So all these things will be in available in the Google's neighborly app. So this app is being rolled down in Bangalore and Delhi for the first time. So next, as on the time, in the next weeks there will be rollout in Chennai, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Pune, okay, as the week passes by. So this is the Google's neighborly app. So this you have to remember. So this was some of the important articles in today's Hindu. So if you like the video, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get the regular notifications. Thank you.